Hi everyone, it's Michelle Taylor, licensed professional clinical counselor, here again, and today what I want to talk about is how to reduce anxiety or depressive thoughts in the moment. And I get this question a lot from clients because sometimes they get so overwhelmed with anxiety or depression that their emotions take over almost completely take over their body, and they're not able to function either at work or at home or, you know, at school. So I wanted to give one tool, one tip on how to, just for a brief moment or as long as you do it, just to relieve those symptoms for just a moment. And later on, I'll talk about a little bit more about your thoughts and how to gently guide them to where you want them to go. You can't control your thoughts, but you can definitely choose which ones to focus on. And when you're anxious or depressed, generally you are falling right into the thoughts that are not very healthy for you. So what we want to do is we want to be a little bit more mindful of which thoughts you choose. So we're going to do a little exercise called grounding. There are a lot of techniques out there for grounding. A lot of people use breathing, a lot of people use body scans, they use mindfulness techniques. My preferred thing for grounding is just such a simple tool, and this is how it goes. So basically, let's just imagine you're in the middle of a very stressful situation. Let's say your parent calls you and puts you in a really funky mood, and you just cannot get your mind off of it. You're just overwhelmed with emotion. Or maybe you experienced a death in a family or a friend, and you're just overwhelmed with emotion, and you're just exhausted. You're tired of crying, and you want to gain some control, some rationalization back to your brain and your emotions. Your emotions are so strong. It comes from your amygdala, and in your amygdala, it's just like fight, flight, or freeze. Like, you just, in that moment, you can't control it. It's just, it is what it is. So what this is a tool just to help you gain control over yourself and emotionally regulate a little bit better. So this is called grounding, and I really love this technique. It is so simple and almost stupid. It's so simple, but you could do it anywhere. I do it when I'm in the car, when I'm feeling really anxious and there's a lot of traffic and I'm feeling anxiety and anger and all this stuff coming up. I do this and I practice it to help myself emotionally regulate more. Sometimes it doesn't work, but sometimes it does. So it's just one tool. Don't take it for this is going to cure everything. It is just one tool in your huge toolbox of stuff that hopefully I'll give you. So grounding. My version of grounding is kind of like the game of scattergories, where you have a category and then you name a lot of things within that category. Except an easier way to do it is just looking around your room, and you basically want to just kind of, it's called grounding for a reason, because your mind is here and there and here and there, and it's just everywhere but here in the ground. And you are here in the present right now. You're okay, you're breathing, you're all right. That's what you have to remind yourself. All of this stuff that goes on your head is not real. It's just you and your thoughts. It's just imaginary. It is not in the present moment. What is real is you right here, right now in your body. And that's what grounding does. It pulls you back into this space of calm and breathing and stuff like that. So breathing is one technique. We'll go over that in another YouTube. So here's the grounding technique. I'm going to look around the room and I'm going to say the object and the color right after it. It's so simple. All I do is I just pick some things, so gray computer, black screen, red pillow, red cup, blue coffee cup, blue water jug, black chair, black curtains, green broom, red or gray headband, black eyeglasses, black shirt. So that's just an example of just something really quick. If you're in your car, you're going to see a lot more things. I'm in a little room, so there's not much more to see, but you notice that it was very challenging for me at times to put a word to what I'm seeing. And that's what it does. It brings your mind from the emotion, which is here, to rational, which is here, intellectual, which is here. So your brain can't do two things at once. Just like, you know, you want to bring yourself from the emotional part to the rational part. and from your amygdala to your prefrontal cortex. And when you do that, you're grounding yourself, you're pulling yourself out of the emotion, and you're able to calm down a little bit more and emotionally regulate a little bit more. You're not thinking about anything exciting. It really is kind of boring to name colors and things around you, but it does bring you in the moment. You're right here, you're around these things that have colors, and you're no longer in the space of this emotional world around your head. So it just for that moment that you're doing that, it gets your mind off of what is really dragging you down or giving you anxiety or depression. So again, some people this works really great, and some people they're just like, this tool doesn't work for me. And there's other tools. So again, this is just one little tool in the toolbox. So keep it in your back pocket. It may be useful, especially if you're in a classroom and you can't handle the teacher, something like that. Anything that causes you anxiety, do this. It's really great. And you can practice it more and more and get better and better at it. So again, if you want more tools and techniques to have some more emotional regulation, stay tuned and subscribe to my channel. Thanks.